أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Inshallah, we'll continue today, inshallah, second episode from the Shepherd of the Ant, Surah An-Naml, inshallah. We start, inshallah, tonight from the verse number 4. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty Azza wa Jal said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ زَيَّنَّا لَهُمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ فَهُمْ يَعْمَهُونَ أولئك الذين لهم سوء العذاب وهم في الآخرة هم الأخسرون. The meaning of this ayat from Nur al-Bayan, but for those who do not believe in the hereafter. Why Allah said that before? Because the ayat before that, Allah was talking about the believers, those who believe in the oneness of Allah, and they believe in the hereafter, and those who are established the prayer, and those who are giving charity zakah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing us the opposite of these people, the opposite of those who believe, those who deny the faith. And Allah did not mention the prayer and zakah here, because if somebody don't believe in Allah, automatically he don't believe in the prayer, he don't believe in the charity, he don't believe in anything, the kalif. That's why he said Almighty Azza wa Jal, but for those who do not believe in the hereafter, we beautify their deeds so it looks good in their eyes, and they are always confused about it, about the hereafter, about their deeds. Those will receive humiliation in this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said لَهُمْ سُوءُ الْعَذَابِ وَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ الْأَخْسَرُونَ. In this life they will receive humiliation in this life and great loss in the hereafter. Let's see these two ayat, and we'll go through these ayat in details. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as I said before, the verses number 3 and 2, Allah was talking about the believers, those who believe in the oneness of Allah, those who believe in the hereafter, and they are preparing themselves for that day by doing their prayers, establishing the prayers, and giving charity, and doing taklif, the good deeds. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the opposite. Why? He's giving you the opposite. He show you the believers and what they are doing and with their deeds, and the disbelievers what they are doing, their bad deeds. And you compare, you are in junction between both. You choose which one of them you want to go. Allah is doing like that. He show you the Jannah, paradise, and the hellfire, and the work of Jannah and the work of the hellfire, the reward and the punishment, and you choose. Because he give you the choice, full choice in this life. This is up to you. But that's why he said, these people, those who are denying the hereafter, they are not praying, they are not doing nothing. زَيَّنَّا لَهُمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ. Allah beautified their deeds to them. We have two meanings here. Beautified their deeds, the good deeds for the mu'mineen, is first meaning. He said the prayer is good. Prayer is connection with God. Prayer is recharging your heart with faith. And giving charity, that's to protect your money and your wealth. Give charity to others. Because if you will be poor, might be somebody going to give you later. See, and Allah is telling you, in the Holy Quran, subhanahu wa ta'ala, too many ayat about that. For example, Surah Hujurat, وَالَّذِي حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْإِيمَانَ وَزَيَّنَهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ وَكَرَّهَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِصْيَانَ أُولَئِكَ الرَّاشِدُونَ. Allah, the one who beautified the faith to you, and he makes the kufr, the disbelief, bad for you. Subhanallah. Those who will be guided, those who love the faith, God, prayer, masjid, the religion, those who are near to God, Allah beautified these good deeds to them. And second thing is, for the believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made these bad deeds looks ugly and bad for the believers. Like, for example, the believers, they don't lie. Lies is not good for them. They cannot lie. The believers, they cannot take bribery, rishwa, and they cannot make corruption on earth. Believers cannot kill people, cannot take their money, cannot lie, cannot do bad things. Otherwise, they are not believers. They are not believers. If they are harming others, there is no harm in Islam. Islam said that harm
must the harm must be removed in Islam. There is no harm in Islam. Yes. And second meaning is Allah beautified for the disbelievers their bad deeds. Because the disbelievers, when they come to the point, their hearts will be sealed. No light will go into their hearts, and no disbelief and darkness will get out from their hearts. Means their hearts will be locked. And Allah will block it, will seal it with disbelief. They will never gonna change. They are astray. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, if you like to be a disbeliever, you like this way, I will help you to be a disbeliever. I will not guide you. I will help you to be bad because you like this. You like it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَفَمَنْ زُيِّنَ لَهُ سُوءُ عَمَلِهِ فَرَآهُ حَسَنًا Surah Fatir, verse number 8. If somebody, his shaitan, Satan, devils, beautified his bad deeds to him, and they think they are doing good. Like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the end of Surah Al-Kahf. قُلْ هَلْ أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالَ الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا Allah said, I will tell you about the losers. Those who are doing good bad deeds, and they think they are doing good deeds while they are making bad deeds. They are the losers. فالشيطان is beautifying these bad things to these people. And also, فهم في زين لهم أعمالهم فهم يعمهون يعمهون here the meaning of this ayah according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala they are always confused about it يعمه يعني متحير somebody in the middle of nowhere he's in confusion these people because of their bad deeds you don't know there is they have no direction they lost because of their bad deeds Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sealed their hearts he sealed their eyes They don't know what they are doing. And look at people around you outside. They are like, they don't know what to do. They don't know where are you going? Where are they going? Everybody's doing unbelievable things. Subhanallah. Yes, فهم متحيرون. They are in confusion. They don't know where to go. Subhanallah. طيب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said verse number 5. أولئك الذين لهم سوء العذاب. وهم في الآخرة هم الأخسرون. الأخسر مبالغة في الخسران. الأخسرون ما هي دي نصي الخاسرون الخاسرون ما بي will lose once الله said that الخاسر خاسر فاعل يعني ما بي once but الأخسر أفعل التفضيل يعني مبالغة في الخسار يعني they are losing all the time أولئك هم الأخسرون طيب الله سبحانه وتعالى said these people they're gonna lose twice how first they're gonna go to hellfire they will be punished second last for them they will not enter paradise Jannah heaven I mean, they're going to lose twice in dunya and the akhirah. Their life will be miserable. And in the hereafter, they will go to hellfire and they lose heaven. Means they're going to lose twice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. Okay. Let's see verse number 6. They will be humiliated and they're going to be in big loss in the hereafter. Verse number 6. وَإِنَّكَ لَتُلَقَّ الْقُرْآنَ مِنْ لَدُنْ حَكِيمٍ عَلِيمٍ Allah, look at this ayah. And you, O Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him. You, O Muhammad, O Prophet, you are receiving the Holy Quran, the Quran from Allah, the all-wise, al-hakim, and the all-knowing, al-alim, subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the meaning of this ayah, this verse? O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, You receive this Quran from Allah, the all-wise, the all-knowing, Hakim and Alim. The all-wise, Al-Hakim, he knows how to put everything in its spot. Hikmah, out of his wisdom. He knows what he's doing. Alim, he's all-knowing. يعني plus Hikmah and Ilm, they are perfect. Somebody Alim, he knows everything. And Hakim, wise, he knows what to do with his knowledge too. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talk about certain things, in the Quran and he gives you rules in the Quran O Muhammad and he punish someone and he rewards someone because he know this is out of his wisdom and knowledge the one in our civil court here in the court in United States or in the world the court of this life you know in these countries they have law and through that law the judges they are putting the reward of someone or the punish of someone Because they study law and they know the system. What about Allah, the creator? He is the one who created all of us. He knows how to reward and who will be rewarded because of his good deeds. And he knows how to punish and who will be punished. And you have the same system in this life too. Somebody's killing someone, take him to the jail and execute him because he killed people. Same thing in the hereafter. Don't be surprised if somebody saying Allah is preparing hellfire for you. It's normal. Maybe these people, they make mischief and they kill people in dunya, in this world of life. They have to be punished. Those who are good, do you think Allah will treat them equally to those who are bad? Even in our law, it's thawab al-iqab is mawgood, you know? So we have to know that. Verse number 7, I have a title for this verse here. Or these verses, Prophet Moses and some of his miracles. طبعاً this ayat from 7 to 14, we're going to talk about Prophet Musa. Allah. طبعا already Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Prophet Musa in the chapter of the poets. At the last chapter I was explaining, we talk about 7 prophets. One of them, Prophet Musa. I talk about Noah, I talk about Lot, and the homosexual people, and I talk about Prophet Musa. I talk about Shu'aib, I talk about Prophet Hud. I talk about Prophet Saleh, 7 prophets, Prophet Ibrahim. I talk about these prophets in the last chapter, the chapter of the poets. Now Allah is mentioning Musa again, Prophet Moses. Yes, yes, for a reason. Because Bani Israel, children of Jacob, they give hard time to their prophets. And they were stubborn and they had ego. That's why each prophet, he came to Bani Israel. They had too many prophets. Like if somebody sick, and this somebody sick has too many diseases. He's a lot of illness. He need to make consult with too many doctors to fix this illness or diseases for them. That's why Bani Israel the same. They came in different, too many messengers, they came from them. Why? Is that good? It's not good. It's bad because they make a lot of mistakes. Because they killed too many prophets. Because they did a lot. That's why God sent too many of these prophets to them to fix them. This is not something good for these people, you know. That's why Prophet Musa, Allah mentioned him the most, even more than Prophet Muhammad in the Holy Quran. More than 65 of the stories of the Quran about Prophet Moses and Bani Israel. Why? To tell us as Muslims and those who are coming after them, do not do and repeat the same mistakes they used to do with Prophet Musa and their prophets. And to be honest with you, Muslim Ummah, they are doing the same mistakes and worse. Yes, I'm going to declare it from here. We are, Haji Kamal told me that we need too many doctors, Haji Kamal. Where Rasulullah is a final, alayhi salatu wasalam, but the Muslim Ummah, where Allah warned us in the Holy Quran, we are doing the same and more. We are doing the same mistakes. But there is no prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the Quran has everything. There is no excuse. Everything in the Quran and the examples and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. إحنا ربا واردون، adultery واردون، fornication واردون، killing واردون، cheating واردون، lying واردون. Everything we are doing. Yes, this is. We need too many doctors nowadays to fix our problems. صراحة. So that's why I'm telling you why Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned. Allah is not repeating Sayyidina Musa in the Quran just like that. No. Sometimes Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in certain condition, he gave up. He was tired from his people. And the responsibility of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was greater and bigger than from any prophets before him. Why? Because Allah used to send the prophets or the messenger for his own tribe and his own people. That's all. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Allah has just sent him, he sent him to the whole entire mankind. That's why he said, we have sent you, O Muhammad, as a mercy to the all mankind. If Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is no message after Muhammad. Muhammad is a final. طيب, is the religion of Muhammad is different from Moses and Jesus? No, it's a continuation. Moses, he worship Allah, God, the God of Muhammad. Jesus, he worship Allah, the God of Muhammad. طيب, means the Christianity, Judaism, Islam, they come from the same source. Allah, the creator. See? But that's why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was the continuation and the final. If you read the Bible, the meaning of the Bible here in the Quran. If you read the Quran as if you read the Torah. If you read the Quran as if you read the 100 scrolls of the prophets before. If you read the Quran as if you read the Psalms of David. means the whole entire books, scriptures, it is in the Quran. Read the Quran, understand it as if you read the Torah, as if you read. Like Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, did he read any book before this Quran? No, he was illiterate. He did not know how to read and write. Somebody said he get this Quran from the Torah and the Bible. No. Prophet Muhammad, he never read any books in his life. He just get this Quran through Jibreel from Allah because he was illiterate. He did not know how to read and write. He was just a shepherd in the desert. He never studied in any school, Prophet Muhammad. If you give him the letters in Arabic, he did not know anything. Just he deliver what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make his heart like a recorder and his mind. سَنُقْرِيُكَ فَلَا تَنْسَى. We're going to give you the Quran, you will never going to forget it. Jibreel will review it with you, Angel Gabriel. And they give it to the Sahaba, they write it down, and we have it. Subhanallah. But that's why sometimes Rasulullah he been hurt by his people. In certain condition, Allah sent him certain message and reminded him about Musa, about David, about Solomon, about Prophet Ibrahim, how they throw him in the fire. About these prophets to make him firm and steadfast again. Don't worry. Do you know what happened to Joseph, Prophet Joseph? Yeah, look at the story. You have the whole entire surah in the chapter of Joseph. The whole entire story. See what happened to him? Stand up, Muhammad, again. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Continue your da'wah. Don't worry about these people. They used to harm him physically, mentally, spiritually. They did a lot against Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his family. Even his wife, they accused them. But the point here is, Allah is not repeating the stories just for repeating. It is not a movie. No. He gave this part of the story to serve this part of the meaning in this surah. You got it? Allah is not just repeating just like that. That's why here, in verse, he's mentioning, I'm going to say it very fast because of time. He mentioned the story or part of the story of Sayyidina Musa. Let me read it for you. إذ قال موسى لأهله إني آنست نارا سآتيكم منها بخبر أو آتيكم بشهاب قبس لعلكم تصطلون. And mention the story of Moses when he traveled with his family from Midian to Egypt after he stayed in Midian in Jordan working for as a shepherd for 10 years. At night he took his wife and his servants and his maybe children and sheep, and he moved from Jordan going at night to Egypt back. And he told them, it was so cold at night, darkness, to wait for him. He told his wife, Umkuthu, يعني stay here. Umkuthu more than one, a group. Umkuthu, stay here, don't move. His wife said, are you going to leave us here in this dark? He said, don't come. Might be I will feel somebody going to harm me there. You stay away from the harm. He found that fire. He seeks some fire to give them warmth, saying, I will bring you some of it from this fire. Okay, this is just what I told you. Okay, verse number 8 to 12. فَلَمَّا جَاءَهَا نُودِيَ أَنْ بُورِكَ مَنْ فِي النَّارِ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ يَا مُوسَى, Allah is talking to Musa now, إِنَّهُ أَنَا اللَّهُ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ وَأَلْقِ عَصَاكَ فَلَمَّا رَآهَا تهتز كأنها جان ولا مدبرا ولا مدبرا ولم يعقب يا موسى لا تخف إني لا يخاف لدي المرسلون إلا من ظلم طبعا إلا من ظلم ثم بدل حسنا بعد سوء فإني غفور رحيم وأدخل يدك في جيبك تخرج بيضاء من غير سوء في 9 آيات إلى فرعون وقومه إنهم كانوا قوما فاسقين. Look at the meaning of this ayat, and then I'm going to give you the general meaning too. So when Musa approached the fire, he told his wife and his servants and his shepherd with him, Umkuthu, it's more than one. Stay here. I see fire far away from you. His wife said, are you going to leave us? He said, Umkuthu, just stay here. Don't make arguments with me. Stay here. I don't need any harm for you. Stay here. And he left to get, it was called to get some guidance from this fire or warmth it's called from this fire. And what happened is, when he approached the fire, he was called. What? He heard the sound from the tree. He found the tree and the branch of the tree fire there. And he was called, blessed is he who approaches this fire. What kind of barakah? Blessings from the fire. First of all, you have to understand this fire, more he see the fire increased in the branch of the tree, more
he see the branch of the tree became green more. What? Green must be dry because of the fire. More fire, more the branch became green. More. What is this? This is not normal fire. And said, bless the, what kind of blessing in the fire? Fire burning. That thing which is cannot be burned in the fire could be angel. Angels cannot be burned from the fire. Aywa. And what happened? As for divine light, and blessed is who is this sacred place. And all praise to Allah. All praise to Allah, the Lord of all the worlds. Oh Moses, Allah is talking to Musa now. The fact is that I am Allah. Allah is talking to Musa alayhi salam. The Almighty, the All-Wise, Al-Aziz Al-Hakim. Musa, now Sayyidina Musa is getting order. Allah is talking about his stick, staff. The Surah Taha said, وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى. What is in your hand, يَا مُوسَى? And Sayyidina Musa, he can say, this is my staff, وخلاص, that's it. He said, no, no, no. Sayyidina Musa, he likes to talk to Allah more. When Allah asked him, what is in your hand? So, قال, هي عصاي, this is my staff. أتوكو عليها, when I walk, I lay on it. Huh? Allah did not ask him about what you do with the staff, with the stick. وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَى غَنَمِي. And also, يَا رَبِّ, I hit the leaves of the trees with my staff, and you know the sheep they are eating from these leaves. Well, yeah, and I have too many benefits out of it. Allah said, no, no, no. Forget about what you're telling me now. In this surah, Allah declared, He said, no, no, no. I have certain job for this stick or staff again, greater than what He said. What? Look what did He say? And put your staff on the ground. Put your staff. Throw it in the ground. When Moses, look at this, put it down his staff. He saw it turning into a snake. A snake different from the female snake, al-hay. A snake means what? The thuban in Arabic, the snake moves very fast. Al-hayya, the female one, it's heavy, big, and moving slowly. The female snake. Tamam? But here, Allah described it as a snake. Means it's moving very fast like a jinni, like a jan. And look what happened to Sayyidina Musa. Sayyidina Musa, guys, he was very strong. Allah gives him the power of 60 or 46 strong men. And look how he's scared. Look what happened to him. When Moses put it down, he saw it turning into a snake. And he got scared. What? He's scared. Yes, he's scared. Subhanallah. So he turned his back, returning. What happened to him? He just bore it. And start the snake moving like a jinni very fast. And Sayyidina Musa, he turned his back and he was running away. He did not even look back because out of his fear. And Allah said, Musa, Musa, come, come, come. You're a messenger. إِنَّ لَا يَخَافُ لَدَيَا الْمُرْسَلُونَ. He's scared. Come back. Come back. Allah called him. And subhanAllah, he said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he did not look behind. Then we said, oh Moses, do not fear, man. Listen, you're a messenger. Indeed, I am the one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, in his presence, messengers should not fear. But Sayyidina Musa is scared. Except the one who commits a sin. Who did commit a sin? Did Musa commit a sin? Yes, he did. What did he do? He killed the Qibtics. Yes. And Allah said, إِلَّا مَنْ ظَلَمْ. See, even Allah blamed him about that. He was not a prophet during that time. And he did not mean to kill him. Just he booked him. And the man died. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, except the one who committed a sin. Who did the sin? Musa. But did Musa repent? He said, yes. He said, إِنِّي ظَلَمْتُ نَفْسِي فَغْفِرْ لِي فَغَفَرَ لَهُ. Oh Allah, I did oppress myself. Forgive me. And Allah forgive him. Then repent. And he changed his act to good deeds. Now, if you make any bad deed, if you repent and you replace that bad deed with something good, Allah will accept it from you. Your forgiveness. And Musa did, alayhi salam. He did. He said, I am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to such a person, most forgiving, very merciful. Allah will forgive him and he will have mercy on him too. Now we learn from this. You make any mistake, astaghfirullah, I repent to Allah, and you make good deeds instead of this bad deed. Allah will forgive you and Allah will have mercy on you, like Sayyidina Musa. And put your hand in your pocket. This is second sign. Tayyib. It will come out of sparkling white with no harm. He was not sick. His hand became white, sparkling white. Why Sayyidina Musa, if you look at his skin, He was Egyptian. He used to live in the upper of Egypt. His skin was like brown, close to dark, like this. But when he put his hand in his under his armpit in his bucket, and he showed to them, he was Subhanallah, sparkling white to them. This is second miracle. These are two signs from amongst nine signs Allah gave it to Sayyidina Musa, which you shall show to the Pharaoh and his people. They are truly rebellious people. This is third time Allah described the people of Pharaoh, the Egyptian during his time, rebellious, fasiqin. فَاسْتَخَفَّ قَوْمَهُ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمًا فَاسِقِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said also in this ayah here, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمًا فَاسِقِينَ. And he described them in Surah Al-Shu'ara, he said, أَنِئْتِ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. He described them ظَالِمِينَ. Why? Why? Because they worship this stupid guy. He's human like you. Why you worship him? To be ظالم, to be فاسق, rebellious or unjust person, this is not good. And Allah described, he told Musa in the beginning, don't go to Fir'aun. Fir'aun is nothing. Go to his people first. Because they are the one who give him the room to be Fir'aun. See? أَنِئْتِ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ قَوْمَ فِرْعَوْنَ. Go to the ظَالِمِين first. Call them to stop worshipping him. Then when he asked him, Allah gives Musa order to go to Fir'aun, not to worship Allah. No, Fir'aun was claiming that he's higher than Allah, his God. But what Sayyidina Musa did, go to him for what? And أرسل معي بني إسرائيل ولا تعذبهم. Just release بني إسرائيل from this slavery. Don't enslave them and don't punish them. That's it. About you, Fir'aun, who cares? Allah will destroy you one day. Don't worry about you. Because he's not, the man is claiming his God. Do you think Sayyidina Musa is telling him, come worship Allah? And he believed, but it was too late. When he was drowning in the Red Sea, Jibreel عليه السلام used to get the mud and he used to put it into his mouth. And he said, I believe. Now it's over. خلاص يا حبيبي. اللي ضرب ضرب والهرب هرب اجري روح عند امك راحت خلاص said I believe امنت خلاص راحت عليك why because he was in the process of death because he was in the process of death that's done خلاص and the رسول الله said that Allah accept your tawbah repentance but in two cases he will never gonna accept it from you if the sun comes from the west and if your روح go to your throat ايوه if your روح will reach your throat you say I believe now it's too late like Pharaoh سبحان الله طيب let's see the last two آيات فلما جاءتهم آياتنا مبصرة قالوا هذا سحر مبين فلما جاءتهم آياتنا مبصرة الله سبحانه وتعالى said قالوا هذا سحر مبين this ayah الله سبحانه وتعالى is saying so when our signs come to them as an eye opener there is no doubt about it Nine signs. Allah mentioned two. His hand became like a sparkling light, became very light, and his staff became big snake running like a jan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the snake in three things. He said, Hayya one time, big snake like a female of the snake. And sometimes in this ayah here, he said a snake moving like a jinni, and he described it as a jinni too. Because the jinn, it's a small snake of the male of the snake. They call him jinni. But that's why Allah said jinn is moving so much. Moving so much, jinn is moving so much. Allah described the snake like this. But Sayyidina Musa is scared. And when he tried to get it back, he was putting something like around his hand. Because the way the snake opening his mouth, Sayyidina Musa, he must put his hand into the mouth of the snake. And then he take it like this. And he gets something and he put it around his the snake because he's scared from the harm. And Allah said, Ya Musa, this is going to prevent you from the harm of the snake. Take it away. SubhanAllah. I am the one who protects you. You are a messenger, Ya Musa. You are a messenger, Ya Musa. So anyway, they deny the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they were in doubt. No, wallahi. They never became in doubt. Like the kuffar of Quraysh. They knew 100% that Rasulullah is Rasulullah. But out of their stubbornness, out of their ego, out of their arrogance, they denied Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The same thing the people of Pharaoh. Last ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وجحدوا بها واستيقنتها أنفسهم ظلما وعلوا فانظر كيف كان عاقبة المفسدين Allah described these people again مفسدين He said فاسقين He said ظالمين And he said now مفسدين too about the people of Fir'aun See because they give the room to Fir'aun to be Fir'aun If they stopped him he will never be Fir'aun He will never gonna stand And he said I am your God See But that's all you have to get to win a message from that And they rejected the signs out of sheer injustice and arrogance. Although in their hearts they were convinced of the truth. Oh, see, they believe it. In their hearts, yes, Musa is a prophet, is a messenger. Muhammad is a messenger. Jesus is a messenger, a prophet. He's not God or son of God. See, they, in their hearts, they were convinced of the truth. واستيقنتها أنفسهم. See how terrible is the destiny of those transgressors. Allah caused them to get drowned in the sea. As you know, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished these people. But that's why, brothers, we have to know that. If you know the truth, do not deny it. Because if you deny the truth, you're going to be similar to these people. And this is al-kibr, like what Rasulullah said that. He said al-kibr, arrogant, somebody became arrogant, not because he's wearing good clothes or he looks good. No. The arrogance when رد الحق غمط الحق أو غمص الناس. When you became arrogant, if somebody saying you the truth, he said, no, I don't believe. Like Abu Jahl. And وغمص الناس or غمط الناس when you look to the people from above, I'm better than everybody. I have knowledge more than anybody. People, they are not equal to me. If you come to this point, this is kibr, like this people. No, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. فَتَعَالَوْا عَلَى الْحَقِّ. They rejected the truth. They became corruptors. And تَعَالَوْا عَلَى عِبَادِ اللَّهِ. And they did not follow the messengers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed these people. They've been drowned. And Allah humiliated them in dunya and in hereafter. وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةِ أَدْخِلُوا أَهْلَ فِرْعَوْنَ أَشَدَّ الْعَذَابِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after their destruction, He gave their dwellings, Egypt, to those who were weak and they handled and they inherited from the Pharaoh and his people. So, subhanAllah, وَأَوْرَثَكُمْ أَرْضَهُمْ وَدِيَارَهُمْ. So I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabb, to give us the knowledge to learn from this Quran between these lines, how to get the benefit. It is not just to read the Quran and say barakah. I want you to understand the message, very important. Because the more you read it and you understand it, more really Allah will enlighten your eyes and your heart and give you basair, enlightenment. JazakAllah khair, we continue tomorrow, inshallah.